Hi everyone and welcome back. Today I have a fun video where I'm going to show you how you can make the most out of your supplies. So I will use just one die and I'm going to show you 5 different ways that you can work with it. For my demonstration today I decided to go with this boho circle. It is an intricate design and let's start with the first technique. First of all, let's use the die as it was intended. So I'm going to place that on top of a square cardstock and I'm going to die cut it. Since I did a lot of die cutting for this video, I actually used my Gemini, which is an electric machine and does die cutting of intricate designs really beautifully. But if you are going to use a manual die cutting machine, then I would suggest to use a metal shim. For the first technique, I did cut out the lovely design and then I'm going to work on a similar sized piece of cardstock and this time I'm going to do some blending. You can have fun, you can use as a background any pattern paper that you have or even create completely different backgrounds like random backgrounds or use your inks for that. Just go for it. In this case, I'm going with a rainbow color order and I'm going to start from the center all the way out. Now as you see, I don't even care if these colors are blended because it's not going to show after all when I place the die cut piece on top. I'm using my sponges for that just because I feel that I can have more control of where I'm applying the color, but anything works for this technique. And although this background looks super ugly, it looks beautiful when you place the design on top. Now, if you see, the paper due to die cutting isn't completely flat. That's why I need to add just a tiny strip of foam tape at the center to make sure that it's not going to fall there. I'm also going to use foam squares on the corners and stick one on top of the other. I'm going to stick this panel on top of a square small card that's 4 1/4 by 4 1/4 and I just added a sentiment at the center. All the cards today are going to be quite simple as I'm mainly focusing on the techniques rather on the design, but you can see how quick and simple I was able to put this card together. If you notice, this die doesn't cut out on the outside, so you just get an intricate design at the center of your paper. However, for the next technique, I'm going to use a circle die that fits on the outside so that I can create a medallion. I'm going to die cut it just by using a fancy paper that I have on my stash. For that, I decided to go with this iridescent one. I'm going to die cut it a couple of times, but before laying them on top, I'm going to add some double-sided tape at the back. This way, when I die cut the medallions, they are going to be already stickers, so it is easier for me to stick them on top of my card. But of course, you can use spray adhesive or even your glue. After running it through my die cutting machine, you can see that it comes out completely clean. All the bits and pieces from the inside of this intricate design stayed inside the die. So just to make sure that this is nice and clean for the next cutout, I used a paper towel to stick everything on top. But this is where I found out that this would make a great technique, since I could have done the same instead of a paper towel on top of a paper, and this way I would get the same design but with the spare little bits and pieces. So I will keep that in mind for another card. So in the first technique, I did use the die to create a kind of a window with a lovely design where you could see through at the back the inking. In this case, I am die cutting bits and pieces which I'm going to stick on top of a card. This way I create a little bit of dimension and I'm adding that extra something by using a lovely cardstock. With my large scissors I'm cutting out any excess so that I can stick it in other parts of the card. All you need to do is to add a sentiment. For that I went with thankful. It's a simple design that you can easily mass produce, especially if you do all the die cutting in the beginning. For the next technique, I'm going to use a spare design that I have from die cutting the previous card. And this is one that I die cut without using the circle all around. So this time I'm going to use this one as a stencil. So just use your dies to create your very own stencil that you can use again and again. Now this is sticky at the back, but I removed the too much stickiness by sticking it on my clothes a couple of times so that I can easily remove it. But it's great to have a sticky kind of stencil on your project so that when you use the paste, it's not going to go underneath. I did use some washi tape on the outside just to make sure that I'm not going to make any mess, and I'm going for it. You can use any paste that you have at home. It can be modeling paste, it can be embossing paste, it can be any glitter paste that you may have, even stickles or your embellishment mousse if you have the Nuvo ones. I went with these glacier pastes by Nuvo, which I haven't used that much, and it was time to give them some love. So I'm actually mixing two of them just to give a more interesting look. I am going to repeat the same process on the other side of my panel, and for this card I decided to go with a slimline card just to show you that there are so many different ways to place just the same die to get completely different look on cards. In the first one I made a smaller square card, the second one was the standard card with three medallions on top, three designs on top. This one will have two designs on each side, but this time on a slimline card. And you see I'm going to change up things for the next two cards. So here is the finished card. All I did was to just stick the word hello on top and place it on top of a silver cardstock. For the next card, I'm going to do one of my favorite mixed media techniques. It gives you awesome results, and it's called dry brushing. So all I did was to die cut this medallion one time. For that, I did use the actual die and the circle on the outside. I'm working black on black here, and this really is important for the look and the technique that I am going for. So I have a black panel here, and I'm going to stick both these designs on top and at the bottom. You can use any type of glue that you like. I did go with my gel medium, but you can use your spray adhesive, you can use your white glue, anything works. So here I have the two halves, top and bottom, on top of a black panel, which is on top of another black panel, slightly bigger, so I do have a little frame. Now I have a blob of acrylic paint here. This is a copper acrylic paint, and I'm going to use a fluffy brush. My brush is completely dry, and that's really important for the technique. I'm going to load the brush and work it out to make sure that I have the color inside the bristles, but you don't want to have too much. Just dry it out on a scrap piece of paper. So once I'm happy, I'm going to go over the project lightly. It's better to go over the areas again and again to highlight and bring out all that detail and the texture, rather than apply too much acrylic paint and you won't be able to move it at all. Remember, this is completely dry, otherwise it could color pretty much everything. You can get similar looks if you go over the design with your ink pad, just swipe it over really softly. You can get similar results if you use a gilding wax, if you have one of them at home, or you can even use Nuvo mousse, and you can even apply that with your finger. I hope this gives you an idea of what you can do with dies that you already have. Just stick one on top of the other using the same colored cardstock and go over them with a brush and an acrylic paint or any other medium that you have there, just to bring everything to life. And you see, by using just the same... But I went all the way from rainbow color card to simple looking card to even a grungy one. And I will say that it's not about the design, but it's about the technique that you decide to go with. It can change things completely. For the sentiment, I did the same thing. I did die cut the sentiment and out of black cardstock and place it on top of black cardstock again. And then I went over that with my finger and that copper paint. I did add a couple of brads just to add more to the look that I was going for, and here are some finished photos. And finally, for the last card for today, I did cut out the lovely design on a square piece of pink cardstock, and I'm going to go all around with double-sided tape. I'm going to peel it off and stick at the back some acetate. I'm going for a shaker card. So don't forget, you can use your dies to create shaker cards. Very feminine and romantic, but still quite simple to recreate. This is going to be a 5.5 by 5.5 square card, and I went with off-white, kind of a vanilla cardstock. I'm adding my confetti at the center of my square card base, and then on top I'm going to stick my panel. From here, all you have to do is to add a sentiment. I went with a strip of sentiment, but of course you can add a die-cut award. I also did embellish it a little bit with flowers and a few leaves. And I think this video was a great example on how the same design can work for so many different styles. So that was the project for today. Down below you will find links to everything I used to create all my 5 cards. This is actually part of a blog hop as we celebrate the latest release by Simon Says Stamp, and there are giveaways. Make sure to visit my blog, you will find the link down below for all the info. I hope that you had fun, that you got inspired. Don't forget to like and leave me a comment, and I'll see you all next time. Thank you.